how to hit a punching bag properly. Yes, we all want to hit the punching bag. So there's three keys to hitting the punching bag properly. One is footwork. I feel like everything that we do, number one is always going to be footwork. Number two is going to be range. So your range on that bag, that means your distance from your bag. So you got to set that up and it's got to be right. And then number three is how to hit the bag without hurting yourself, right? So learning how to turn your knuckles over or under or to the side to not hurt yourself when you're hitting the punching bag. Those are three keys to hitting the punching bag properly. Three keys to hitting the punching bag properly. First thing is footwork, just like with everything else, it's footwork, right? So I'm in my boxing stance, right foot's to the right, of course. Both my toes are pointed slightly to the right as well. So as I move around this bag, I'm gonna step with my left foot to the left, and then I'm gonna drag my right foot to the left as well. So I'll show you what I'm talking about. Step and drag, step and drag, step and drag. Now the reason that we move left and right and we're hitting the punching bag, especially as a beginner, is because if I move into this bag, I'm gonna push through my shots. This is what I'm talking about. If I'm out here, I'm gonna throw a 1-2, bang, bang, and I step into the bag. I'm gonna end up pushing that bag. Now, I don't know yet as a beginner how to work that bag. So, I don't want my bag to work me. So right now we're gonna move left and right. Even as an advanced fighter, we move left and right, in and out, all different directions, but right now we're moving to the left and the right. Okay, so if I'm moving to the left and I do my step drag, I'm gonna throw a 1-2. It's gonna be a step and then a drag and a rotate on the right hand. Notice that I had extension on my right hand. Really important. You want this bag at the end of your shots, okay? So step back. All right, that's your 1-2. Moving around the bag. Now, if I get all the way over here, maybe there's a bag here, maybe there's a person, or maybe there's not, whatever, but I need to learn how to move to the right. I'm gonna do what's called a shake. All I'm gonna do is jump and do a little scissor kick. Boop! And I'm just kicking my left foot behind me. I'm gonna walk around this bag, and then I'm resetting up in my stance to the right of the bag. If you watch boxing, you're gonna see fighters doing that in the ring the whole time that they're fighting. So that's what I call the shake. So the second thing that's important on this bag is your range. Range is your distance from your bag, from your opponent. So to set that up, I'm gonna be in my boxing stance, of course. I'm gonna stick my left hand out, which is my jab as an orthodox fighter. And I want this jab to just barely touch the bag. So a lot of times I see this, I'll see people go like this, and then they'll just lean their body back like, okay, this is my range. You don't lean back like this in boxing. You slightly have an angle forward. So this is my range, all right? So make sure that that is accurate. If I'm too far out, no bueno, again, too close. So just barely touching the bag, that's your range. Now range is, well, we call this the stick, right? Your jab, you're finding that person with your measuring stick. So that's setting all your punches up. So range, if I'm gonna throw my right hand, boom, it's right at the end of the shot, okay? So range is really, really important. The other thing that's really important is how you hit the bag, meaning turning your knuckles over, under, sideways, whatever, when you're impacting, okay? So if I'm gonna throw my shots, let's say I'm gonna throw a jab, and I pick my elbow out to throw a jab. We know this isn't accurate. I mean, it's not proper, but some people still do it. You're going to impact that bag with the side of your hand here on your pinky. And you don't want to do that. It's really weak on the outside of the hand. You want to turn your knuckles over. You'll notice I'm turning my knuckles over quite a bit. Okay? That's fine. By the time I get to the end of that punch on my bag, it'll look just straight. But really, you can try to turn your hand over even more. It's much more helpful. Right hand, I see a lot of this. I see a lot of that. Elbow out again, hitting with the side here. Not only will you hurt your pinky knuckles in your hand, but you can hurt your wrist, okay? So it's really important to keep your elbow down and then turn the punch over with those first two knuckles. If we're throwing a hook, open the arm up and pull it to where your palm faces you on the left hook around the bag. Now I've seen, I saw a pro one time really hurt their wrist throwing the hook on the bag this way. People do it all the time, that's great, but as a beginner, it's important not to hurt yourself and to really get your mechanics down and start to learn how to throw your shots. So safety-wise, I would throw your hook with palm facing you around the back. Uppercuts. Uppercuts, you're gonna make sure that you are rotating in order to get your elbow under you and the palm facing up. So when you can throw it, make sure you're not throwing it sideways here. Because again, you can hit here, hurt your wrist. So again, rotating here and bringing that punch up and out. Body shots, last one, around the side, boom. If you throw your body shot and you throw it this way with palm down, you're probably gonna end up hurting your wrist on the inside, okay? So palm slightly up when you're throwing those body shots as well. So those are the three pieces you want for hitting the punching bag. You're gonna wanna have good footwork around the back and your range to find the person that you're trying to hit. And then turning your shots over properly so that you don't injure yourself. That's it.